Hello, I'm Luis Nuño. I'm a professor in the area of signal theory and communications at the Polytechnic University of Valencia in Spain. Now I'm going to present an example and composition made with the aid of the musical abacus. We will start with some basic concepts in music, and then I will explain how to use the musical abacus in composition. We will compose several phrases. After that, we will define the full structure of the piece. This is a piece for guitar, and we will include some percussion effects. At the end, we will include a section with the structure chorus verse. The basic elements of music are melody, harmony, and rhythm. In this case, we chose the G major key, and the musical abacus will give us the notes for composing the melody and the harmony, that is, the chords. With respect to the time signature, it will be common time, that is 4/4, and the tempo half note equal to 70. The composition is a song typical from Cuba, which has a syncopated rhythm. We will compose phrases with 8 bars. This is the musical abacus, where we chose the G major key, as we can see in the upper part. This key contains one sharp in the key signature, and that sharp corresponds to note F. In this part, we have the G major scale, with which notes we will compose the melody. In this part, we have the 3 main chords in G major, but for simplicity, we will use only 2 of them: the tonic chord G major, whose notes are G, B, D, and the dominant 7th chord, D dominant 7th, whose notes are D, F sharp, A, C. Now we are going to compose several kinds of phrases, which will be characterized by their harmonic rhythm. The harmonic rhythm is the rate at which the chords change in the musical composition. For example, phrase A will have a harmonic rhythm of 1 chord every 2 measures. The phrase B will have a harmonic rhythm of 1 chord every 3 or 4 measures, ending with the tonic chord G major. And here this is a transition from phrase A to phrase B with a harmonic rhythm of 1 chord per measure. Now, this is the harmony, the 2 chords, which will be used in incomplete form and will have a syncopated rhythm. And with respect to the bass, we will use only the root and the 5th of the chord. So on G major chord, we will use the notes G, D, and on D dominant 7th chord, we will use the notes D, A or A, D. For the melody, as I explained, we will use the notes from the G major scale. We do not have to emphasize the notes which are 1/2 step above a chord note. For example, on G major chord, the note C is 1/2 step above B. So we will not emphasize note C when we are on G major chord. In the same way, on the D dominant 7th chord, the note G is 1/2 step above F sharp. So on this chord, we will not emphasize the note G. Now, this is a phrase A, 1 chord every 2 measures. We can see the melody, some chords which are incomplete and with a syncopated rhythm, and the typical bass in this composition. On G major chord, we can see a note C, but this C, with this D and this other D, these 3 notes can be considered as an anticipation of the next chord, D dominant 7th. And this is, let's listen to phrase A. This is the transition from phrase A to phrase B with 1 chord per measure. And now we have 2 phrases B one chord every three or four measures, ending with a tonic chord, G major. The two phrases are practically the same, except the two last chords, so we call them B and B prime. We can see the melody, some chords, incomplete. Sometimes they have a syncopated rhythm, as here or here, but other times they don't have a syncopated rhythm, as in this case and in this case. Let's listen to these two phrases, B and B prime. B. Now we are going to define the full structure of the piece. It will have a first part with 60 bars, including an introduction, which is half an A phrase, 4 bars, and then phrases A, transition, B, B prime, and then we repeat this section. Phrase A, transition, B, B prime. And then a second part with 80 bars with a structure chorus, verse. The chorus will be an A type phrase and the verse a B type phrase. The sequence will be chorus, verse 4 times and the song will end with 2 choruses. The melody in the verses will change, so we call them B1, B2, B3, B4. Every song has an intrinsic clave rhythm, even if this instrument is not present. There are two clave rhythms, the 2-3, which is this one, and the clave rhythm 3-2, which is this one. In our case, the clave rhythm is 2-3, and we will include it in the chorus, that is, in an A-type phrase. We will play it by striking the guitar top with the ring finger. So here we have a chorus, which is an A-type phrase, one measure, one chord every two measures. Then in the upper part of the staff, we can see the 2-3 clave rhythm, then the melody, and the typical bass. In this case, we didn't include any chord. Let's listen to the chorus. And this is a verse, a B-type phrase, one chord every three or four measures, ending with the tonic chord G major. We can see the melody, some chords which are incomplete and with a syncopated rhythm, and the typical bass. Let's listen to it. To sum up, this composition has a first part with 60 bars, including an introduction, phrase A, transition, B, B prime, and then it repeats this section, and a second part with 80 bars with a structure chorus verse. The composition ends with 2 choruses. The composition is entitled Camino al Oriente, On the Way to the East, and is included in CD Sueños, Dreams. A performance of this piece can be seen on YouTube in channel Rueda Harmonica, which means harmonic wheel. This is the CD Sueños, Dreams, performed by international guitarist Tony Cotoli. You can find all the information on the webpage harmonicwheel.com. Thank you very much for your attention.